Hey Tony, it's Rob from Bandit Industries. Is now a good time? Okay. I'm recording, so whenever you're ready, just go ahead and tell me a little bit about your experiences with Bandit so far.
So my name is Tony Neglia with Makelele Systems, and we're based out of San Diego, California. Currently we have the Bandit 18XP with the gas engine. We worked with a different manufacturer previously, but Bandit has blown it out of the water. We love that machine. Previous manufacturer, you had side-mounted feed wheels, which didn't provide any crushing power, or it didn't really help with infeed of tough stringing material. With the Bandit, we can use down pressure on the upper drum, feed anything into it, it pulls it right in. Minimal risk to personnel trying to feed that machine, and worked out great. That chipper is a breeze compared to what we used to use. We primarily focus on clearing grub, land clearing, and removal. So it just handles that bigger material without having to dedicate that much manpower to it. At the Mira Mesa Park project, clearing grub out there involved the removal of about 68 mature trees, and we essentially chipped everything up to 18 inches in diameter and then firewooded the rest. So that machine was invaluable in getting that project done and reducing our cost for dumping, because we're able to dump those chips for free, whereas the firewood we had to pay to dispose of it. We have seen zero power issues with that gas engine, and we're looking at a comparable consumption rate as to a diesel chipper in that same class. So we've seen zero impact as far as capability. You know, we can feed in the largest of firewood, and that machine regulates itself so well that, you know, I could probably count on both hands the times where it's actually bogged down and shut down, and that's usually because we've been overfeeding the machine. So it's worked just fine in that aspect. We're real aggressive when we feed the chipper, and we can load that with mini X's and skid steers. Prime concern when we're doing that is maybe bending the infeed tray, you know, or putting undue pressure on the feed wheels. And we have had no issues to date, no bending, no warping, no cracked welds, no nothing. So that machine has stood up. We've already got about 500 hours on it, and we have had zero issues as far as wear and tear. I'd recommend strongly to take a Bandit and demo it against whatever other brand that they're putting it up against. And then also speak to a Bandit owner. I think they'll tell you hands down fairly that the machine is awesome and our dealer out here is top notch.